Hello and welcome to Design Inc. This is the third of a series of tutorials on building a Notion dashboard for interior designers. In the first tutorial, we built out our dashboard. In the second tutorial, we created a database for contacts. In this tutorial, we'll be using this database and create different views of it. Then we will create a second database, which is a master link database. And this will contain any link that we come across that we would like to save. We will then connect the contacts database with the master link database. Let's jump in and have a look at the Notion site. In the last tutorial, we created this dashboard and we talked a little bit about what each section is for. But we'll be building out this in a little while later. Let's jump into where we left off, which is our contacts database. Last tutorial, we looked at how to create the main database and also then how to create filters. What we're going to do now, it can be quite annoying to have to come into this main database and look at all these filters. We're going to have links outside of this database. We do this by creating a new page. And we can call this page clients, let's say, and then we hit the table database tab and we look for the database we've already created. And we know that we have had different views that we've set up. We want this to be a clients database. We'll click on the clients view. Now, if you want a different type of view, you can always change the view from here. So last tutorial, I showed you how to filter, and you can certainly create a new view even within this page. But in this case, we're just going to create a client view and we're just going to hit enter and it's already set up. If you have a look here, we've got this client's database. We can add an icon here. Let's say it's a woman. And it's ready to go. And you can keep on doing this for as many. So let's just do it one more time. We're going to create a page. We're going to call this, let's say, trades. We're going to create our database, our table. We're going to go in our contacts. We've already created trades view. And we're just going to copy that view. And there we go. Already done. So we can make this into a hammer. We've got a hammer and we're good to go. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to create a master link database. Now, this is going to be a brand new database. We're going to click this option here and we're going to build out this database. And we're going to use exactly the same type of idea in terms of having a main database and using our sections here to filter out the database rather than creating many different databases. It's just much more efficient to do it this way. We're going to call this, we're going to call it type. And we can add lots of options. We could, for example, call this admin. We could have blog posts. We could have an interior designer. We could have standard operating procedures. We could have social media. And so on. You can actually have as many categories as you want. If you want to sort them out, I always end up just putting them in alphabetical order just to make it a little bit easier to find. But you know, some of my databases in terms of types have quite a number of different options. The next thing we're going to do is I always like to add in a date. So here we can choose our date format. And then I like to add in a URL. We've got our link and we'll call this link. And then we're going to add a checkbox, and this is going to be our quick links. So I like to have a checkbox, and when something is a quick link, I can check that. And then finally, we're going to connect the contact database with this master link database. We do this by creating what is called a relation. And you'll find it under in the advanced section of the property types. We're going to hit that, and we can then choose the database that we want to connect it to. We'd like to connect it to this database here. And if we want to show the relationship on the other database, we can click this toggle here and then add the relationship. Let's say we want to add in a link. So let's say we want to add in Design Inc. Co. And I can say, okay, well, this is an interior designer, and we can add in our date. We can add in our link if we want. Come. So we've got our link. Let's say we do want it to be a quick link, and we can then head over and choose our page. We want to choose Joanne because she's linked with Design Inc. And there we have it here. If we hop back to our contacts page, we can see here, if we look for Joanne, we can see the master link database is here. I hope you found this tutorial useful. Next tutorial, we're going to create a standard operating procedures link database, and we will also create a knowledge vault. See you in the next tutorial.